The starting of a conversation is a difficult thing. I'm bold as a lion on a platform, but in my neighborhood, I'm just another guy, you know? You get a conversation going. Often you start with where they are and go where they should be. Then it just depends on where the person is. You gotta listen and ask a question, ask a leading question, and then wait for the answer and listen. Because people will often reveal where they're thinking, where they're going. And then sometimes if the conversation gets religious or spiritual, you can say, where are you? If you had a chance to talk to God, what would you ask him? And their answer, listen carefully, because their answer will reveal where they're coming from. If they're aggressive, often they've met somebody claiming to be a Christian who was not a nice person, and who probably said, you're going to hell kind of thing, which is not a term of endearment. You know, so you don't open doors by insulting people. You gotta start by showing the love of Christ. To me, it's beautiful to get people understanding the love of God, his forgiveness based on the cross. It cost him a lot to forgive us, but he does forgive. You will find that most people, when you approach them with respect, with the love of God, with a listening ear, they have questions. Almost, I'd say, my experience, 95% minimum, are not reacting against God. They don't want to sell out to any religion. They don't want you to think you're superior to them, and we're not. So when you show the love of Christ, it's amazing how people open up. They may not receive Christ, but they will at least listen. And then you hope the Holy Spirit will keep reminding them for years to come of that conversation, and they will come to know Christ.